നമസ്കാരം വാട്സപ്പിലേക്ക് ഒരിക്കൽ കൂടി സ്വാഗതം പ്രശസ്ത നടിയും നർത്തകിയുമായ ലക്ഷ്മി ഗോപാലസ്വാമിയാണ് വാട്സപ്പിന്റെ ഈ ലക്കത്തിൽ നമ്മളോടൊപ്പം ഉള്ളത് തന്റെ ജീവിതത്തെക്കുറിച്ചും കാഴ്ചപ്പാടുകളെക്കുറിച്ചും ലക്ഷ്മി ഇതിനോടകം പ്രേക്ഷകരുമായി പങ്കുവെച്ചു കഴിഞ്ഞു ചില ചോദ്യങ്ങൾ കൂടി ലക്ഷ്മിയോട് ചോദിക്കാനുണ്ട് മലയാളത്തിൽ സംവദിക്കാൻ അല്പം ബുദ്ധിമുട്ടുള്ളതുകൊണ്ടാണ് ലക്ഷ്മിയുമായുള്ള സംഭാഷണം ഇംഗ്ലീഷിലാക്കിയത് തീർച്ചയായും നമ്മുടെ പ്രേക്ഷകർക്ക് മനസ്സിലാകുന്ന ഭാഷയും സംസാരവും തന്നെയാണ് അതിലുള്ളത് നമുക്ക് ലക്ഷ്മിയോട് കൂടുതൽ സംവദിക്കാം ലക്ഷ്മി സോ ഫാർ വി വർ ടോക്കിംഗ് അബൌട്ട് യുവർ ലൈഫ് യുവർ വ്യൂ പോയിൻറ്സ് ആൻഡ് അതർ തിങ്സ് ലൈക്ക് ദാറ്റ് നൗ ലെറ്റ് മീ ആസ്ക് യു വൺ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ അബൌട്ട് ദ ക്യാരക്ടേഴ്സ് ദാറ്റ് യു ഡു ഇൻ ഫിലിംസ് ഫോർ മെനി ആർട്ടിസ്റ്റ് ദേ ഓൾവേസ് സേ ദാറ്റ് സം ഓഫ് ദ ക്യാരക്ടേഴ്സ് ജസ്റ്റ് റെഫ്യൂസ് ടു ലീവ് ദം ഈവൻ ആഫ്റ്റർ ദ ഫിലിം ദ ഷെഡ്യൂൾ ഈസ് ഓവർ ദ ട്രേസസ് ഓഫ് ദോസ് ക്യാരക്ടേഴ്സ് റിമെയിൻ വിത്തിൻ ദംസെൽവ്സ് ഇൻ യുവർ കേസ് ഡു യു ഹാവ് എനി സച്ച് ക്യാരക്ടർ who has refused to leave you even after so many years?
Because as much as I like every character, I told you, I have a sense of detachment inside. So, yeah. I don't know, but I feel it. Every role will enhance what there is already inside and magnify it. Because all of us have all the rasas. All of us will have even an evil side. It may be 0.1%, it may be 10%, it may be 50%. But when you have a negative role or whatever, it only enhances. You tap into that spot, you know? So yeah. I don't think there is anything that has impacted me. It's acting for me, so I act and I leave it. That's it. But there are a lot of films that are very memorable, as in, of course, films which where the woman is very dignified, who, for example, like a film like Paradeshi, a poet who's stuck in helpless, but she is not, even if she's financially weak, she doesn't want to ask for some food or whatever. Or if you say, what should I say? I can't think of very many. Shikar.
Right. Shikar. Yes.
I can think of Taniye.
That's a beautiful movie.
Who's so professional. Taniye is one of my favorite movies in acting and the experience in being under Babu Thiruvilla. Nadumudi Venu sir was like a guru to me at the time. Acting guru, really. So I think, these I could probably. And Kamboji, because it was a dance and it was me and all that, very close to my heart. Okay. But
when you talk about women characters, strong and bold women characters, you know, in our mythology, we have so many women characters who are very strong, very bold and original. Not even Mahabharata, Ramayana alone, you have women characters in Upanishads also, Upanishad stories also. In your mind, do you have any such character whom you want to portray in maybe in films or in any other art form?
Well, Ramayana, I can think of Lakshmana's wife. Urmila. And I've heard that there were, I must tell you that I'm not very well read with the Upanishads. I just know the gist of every Upanishad. But I know that during that time, there were some women who would, who had done Upanayana and all these kind of things. So I am curious, it requires research. So I'm curious to know more about these women who were so scholarly, were on par with men. So I don't really know too much. I would like to, I would like to delve into that. But I must say there are so many modern day women that inspire me. I'm saying even during the independence era, because every house will have an inspiring woman.
Definitely.
Yeah, it could even be holding their dance. It could be our Bangalore Nagaratnamma who started the Tiruvayya festival, who got a temple made for Tyagaraja, and who kept, I have heard, because I live in Bangalore, I'm aware about Karnataka history. the so-called Vaishyas, the so-called Vaishyas have contributed to town tanks. So many villages have water thanks to the tanks built by these women with their earnings. They were very, very socially responsible people.
They were called they were called Nagaravadhu, something like that, I think.
So these are the women, they are real women. These are the people who really inspire me. You know, people who have done so much for society, who have thought beyond themselves, in spite of having such conservative, or not even conservative, even limiting power positions, they have gone beyond. So people like that have always inspired.
Okay. There is one question which I can't avoid asking you. It's about, the famous film stars or other famous personalities, their personal life, their relationships, marriage, all, these are always matters of media interest. But in your case, it's not your marriage or anything like that. It's why you are not getting married. That was the question that is being discussed in the media, even till recently. Some people said it's due to a personal relationship that failed, and some people said it's due to your commitment to the profession. You are in front of us. Let me directly ask you, what is the reason?
First of all, I never planned not to get married.
Okay.
It has happened like this. And I was never, of course, but I must tell you, since many, many years, I've always expected a lot of marriage. Maybe that's why I'm not married. Meaning, it should be a fast, it should be an interesting journey. And I would see a lot of these, my typical, and I've spoken about this in many interviews, but I can say it again, no harm. I have always seen for me, this idea of a normal marriage would be then the Santro car. I would see this husband and wife sit there, two kids at the back, both of them looking bored and driving somewhere, maybe going for dinner, but that is also a boring experience. I would look at that and I'd say, I don't want to be like that. If it is something that I feel like, wow, I would love to be with this guy and we can have such a wonderful life together. I'm sure that, I have met a lot of couples like that, I'm not saying no, that I would probably think of marriage. And having said that, it's not that I haven't met a lot of people. I have met with my exposure and with being a very liberal family, I've met so many guys. It's just not worked out. And I want it to be a natural experience where you can't but marry the guy. It shouldn't be that I have to get married. Let me find someone inside in this time frame window. And this guy, okay, in this circumstance, this is the best I could do. I would not like to live like that.
So
that's it. So there is no failed relationship. There is no, a heavy commitment to dance that I'm not married. None of that. But having said that, as an artist, I'm sure there was a lot of me that I wanted to explore. So maybe that, because I would get earlier a lot of proposals in America, like typical many girls. Somehow I never wanted to live abroad, and the kind of guys that I would like or had the caliber would be from there, but somehow I was very attached to India. That's one thing that I have had heavy attachment. Other than my other detachment is really India.
Great.
It's not anything else. So I very strongly feel I belong here. I need to live here. If I want to be happy as an artist, I have to be here. So, and that is probably one thing that limited me. And that's it. And then now at my age, I'm in my late 40s. Then, a lot of the guys that you meet are perhaps married, or there are very few that are actually eligible and available. So, with all these factors together, that's it.
Let me put it in another phrase. Let me rephrase it. The mediocre Indian married life, that is what, frightens you. Can I say like that?
Very right.
Okay.
Very right. Could be phobia. It could be some kind of phobia also. Because I am a very free-spirited person.
Okay.
And I just like to be and you know, explore. I'm very glad my parents have allowed me to be like that. Though I'm not saying that they don't have anxieties, they do. They also feel I wish she could settle down. I'm not, you know, they also have sometimes societal pressure, sometimes they themselves feel, but they also see that me, and I have a lot of single friends. So my mother keeps teasing me. She says, like, you get rid of your friends, you may get married. Like, she teases because I have a lot of happily single friends.
Okay.
So we've all, some chosen, some happened like me, but there is no big difference between even my married friends and us. So that's, it is only that. So there is no major vedane here. I want to make it very clear. Or no, like, what do you say? Life yeah. failure, I nothing like that. As you can see, I think you can see that.
But it's not a close the chapter as well. That is also true, isn't it?
Whatever age, why not? I always have hope. I'm a very romantic person at heart. And I would love a companion. I would love to find somebody who, with whom, because I feel two people, or simply because two people, you can do a lot more in life than one. Okay. You know, many times I would feel, you know, movie, I want to go for a movie at night. And then I have to think, oh, you know, who will take me, you know, sometimes. But now even that I have figured out, I have friends who will take go be that I go out with. So, or to go out and eat.
Definitely.
It's nice to get it's nice to have a buddy, for sure. I'm okay. Open.
Okay.
You just now you said that you took a conscious decision to stay back in India, live here, not to go abroad and live. Let me ask you, what is the prime reason for taking that decision? Is it the culture here? Is it the life here? Or is it the family ties?
I feel here, maybe we are very pampered, maybe. A lot of attention. I have always got a lot of attention since childhood. You know, since I've been a kid, I have always been looked after, touch wood. And, you know, here, in a way, I appreciate this very individualistic society, say in America, where people are very driven, motivated by themselves to do things. But at the same time, here, you wear a sari, 10 people will tell you it's so beautiful. You know, there is, and here, you're invited as an artist. I'm always invited to dance. I don't have to apply somewhere and drive myself and set up the stage myself and dance and bring the audience. You know, I don't have to do any such thing. So I think as an artist, to feel nourished. And also, you know, it's in the air. I'm having said that, but I can also say, now if I look at America and all, there are lots of, you know, now the world has really become a village. There are lots of great artists coming up from every corner of the world, actually. It's cliche. It's now a misnomer to say that you need India. No. But certain things, I like the Indian-ness of being here, you know. It's not about being conservative. It's about being in your own country. Being first citizen in your own country. It's beautiful.
True. One more? Yeah, please.
Including, you know, and also this interaction we have seen. I have a personal interaction with my maid. I have an interaction with the gardener. You know, we are always having so much, there is so much more social life happening here that way. So, I feel I'm happy here.
Okay. How do you see yourself in the industry after, say, 5 years? Let me tell you why I am asking you this question. Many artists we have seen in the later part of their career, you know, they switch over to directing films, even producing films. Do you have any such plans in your, nearby future?
I'm too scared to produce because I have very little hard-earned money and I would like to say that. I'm just too scared. I'm not one who takes discount because I live such a small, my comfort zone is this middle class life I'm very happy with. It's a typical middle class mentality. Mm. But having said that, yeah, I'm not that kind of a risk taker. Mm. Direct also, I'm not, I would rather, I don't think I have the interest to direct right now. I don't know. I would like to act a lot more and I would maybe, because I'm always, in dance, of course, I'd like to do my own so many things. I have been into research, I've been researching stuff. I like putting my thoughts, which test my intellectual capabilities. So I've been giving little talks. In fact, I was on a panel recently with the National Institute of Advanced Studies, which is very nice to talk about the movement of the cells in art. So I've been now dabbling with these kind of things. I enjoyed that. I enjoy that activity, actually, of reading up, thinking. Definitely. So I don't think I have it in me to be a director.
Okay. You know why I asked you this question? Because cinema is such a powerful medium. It can even support and help other art forms, even classical art forms. You must be remembering the impact of films like Shankaraparanam, Sagara Sangamam, etc. So that is why I asked you, because you are a classical dancer. So you can use cinema as a medium.
But that's, you know, why. We have a parallel entertainment going on with YouTube.
Yeah.
With, you know, now we can't, it is in fact stronger sometimes, if you say, than film. So I don't think now that magic has gone. I don't think this era is suitable to do something, unless it's a very rare art form, maybe. But there's enough and more about, say, Bharatanatyam or whatever that you're seeing on YouTube. And you see the kind of viewership some dancers get. It's much more than a hero sometimes. You know what I mean? Of a film.
True.
I think there is no need to do anything to propagate art. But what you can do is showcase good art. So I don't think a film, and say film, I look at film as a catalyst more than dance, as a catalyst for social change.
True.
So film has that, and I've always been aware of it. I've always been aware of my position as a, I'm not a super celebrity, but definitely some well-known personality. I'm very aware of my power that way, where I can, where if I talk, maybe few more people will listen. So yeah. I think that way cinema can be amazing in making people think. That's the power.
Yeah, you are a super celebrity and a celebrity with a vision. That matters really. So, you know, what I was going to ask you, once the normalcy returns, the lockdown is over, what are your current projects? Where are you going to shoot? Things like that.
I have no project right now. Nothing great has come my way. Nobody's called. I mean, I have some few, but nothing great. I don't know that it open up. But in the meanwhile, I have been, I am doing some research in dance now. So that's kept me now, keeping me quite busy. So I'm quite happy with that. And I will perform and let us see. Because I do enjoy cinema. It's not that I don't, because it's, again, I love the challenge of emoting with minimal expression, emoting with the eyes. And, you know, I love portraying characters. So I love cinema. But as you said, my soul is all about music and dance. Okay, that is me, actually. Extension is cinema.
Great to hear that.
You know, after 2 months of lockdown, the life is slowly but surely limping back to normalcy. And, you know, living with corona or living with the virus is going to be the new normal, taking all the precautions. So, in this scenario, what is your message to the viewers, our viewers, Tatumai TV viewers? What do you want to share with them, or what do you want to give them
now,
as a message?
I'm not looking at a wide spectrum. I can't address, for example, somebody having like deep financial crisis because of this. I'm no one to give any advice. Because if you have financial problems, I'm talking about basic, then nothing is going to matter. But the people who do, who can survive during this whole time, it's normal. I think this is a golden time to practice, to listen to nature, a golden time to change our ways, a golden time to do things that are absolutely necessary and not because, including flying, you know, earlier, pre-lockdown, everybody is taking a flight and flying here and there, including me. Well, a lot of times, 90% of the times, I have gone for professional commitments. But if I look at it otherwise, you know, holidaying, like if you didn't fly, then you're not living. But then what about what it's doing to the world, to climate change, carbon footprint. Similarly, can we wear clothes that are more environmental friendly? Can we eat more environment friendly? Because I feel the earth is giving us a very strong message. Not only message, it's threatening us. So I look at it as an artist, I look at it like that. So I think you just have to question, so what really matters to you? Is it, what do you say? I think people, I don't even have to say all these things. I think people will change.
Definitely.
They would have changed.
Definitely.
I think you will be more compassionate. We have to be compassionate. We have to be compassionate towards other people. So I think you can be happier with less is what I'm feeling.
Okay. Thank you very much for spending time with us, speaking to us on a wide range of subjects. It has been a pleasure talking to you because you are not just a film star, but a person with an inner vision, a person with a focus on life ahead. So it was really enjoyable as well as informative talking to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Rajan. Rajesh Pilla.
Thank you. Thank you, Lakshmi. Thank you very much. പ്രശസ്ത നടിയും നർത്തകിയുമായ ലക്ഷ്മി ഗോപാലസ്വാമിയാണ് വാട്സപ്പിൽ നമ്മളോടൊപ്പം ഇത്രയും സമയം ചിലവഴിച്ചത്. വീണ്ടും വാട്സപ്പിൻ്റെ അടുത്ത ലക്കത്തിൽ മറ്റൊരു പ്രമുഖ അതിഥിയുമായി കാണാം. നന്ദി. നമസ്കാരം.